don't believe it.
You know, when I started painting at 8 years old, the thing I did in tandem was sing. And I didn't know which I wanted to do. I kept winning all these singing competitions in the community. And I thought, well, I'm going to sing and I'm going to paint. I wasn't sure which I would do. So I went to art school and graduated with a BFA. And then on top of that, I was singing with bands and big bands. I was doing shows. And I thought, I'm going to just be a singer and the art will stay in the background. But that's not how it happened. It was just sometimes I would be singing, sometimes I'd be doing the artwork, and I loved it all.
I started painting around the age of 8. My mother had a small painting on her wall. It was an oil painting. And one day I took it and I had some oil paints, paint by number oil paints. And I just took out a piece of paper and I started to copy the painting. And my mother went crazy and my father went crazy. And that's when I knew I could be an artist.
I think my favorite things to paint was whatever I was painting at the time. The same thing when I sang, it was whatever I was singing I just fell in love with and just did the best I could. I started out doing something called pointillism, and that's because I was raising kids and setting up paints in the house was not going to happen without it being all over the house. So I got little paint pens, all different colors, and I stippled, which is little dots, and the thing that was great about that is if you made an error, you could just use another different color dot to correct it. And I ended up selling a lot of those works. In fact, a hospital commissioned me to do a large painting for one of their rooms because I was also working in assisted living at the time. And so I got several works of art commissioned doing pointillism, which was great. As the years went on, I was singing in between and I was doing cabaret shows. We were living in Los Angeles at the time, so I was down in LA doing cabaret shows and also being in community shows and love that.
When it came to going to college, I decided I wanted to go to art school, so I went to Tyler School of Art in Philadelphia and graduated. It's the art school of Temple University, which is quite prestigious, and it was a wonderful school to go to.
I had a daughter-in-law who was Hispanic, and she introduced me to Dia de los Muertos, which is Day of the Dead. And we went to a big celebration in LA, and I fell in love with the colors and the excitement and the passion, but more about the idea of what Dia de los Muertos was a celebration of life for those who had died, and that one day people who have passed come back to life. And so they set up ofrendas, which were tables with all their favorite things. So I started to paint. I took lots of photographs where I was, and I would start to paint these people who were celebrating. And I also did sugar skulls, and those started to sell, and people loved them. And I actually had a display at a restaurant where people bought my artwork. So it was very exciting, and I loved doing it. And now we've moved to Philadelphia, or back home. That's where we were raised. And we're back here, and I'm painting the city. So that's my newest love. It's lovely to have all of these artistic endeavors, and makes my life full.
I just want to thank you all so much again. This song I actually recorded on a demo when I was 16 years old, and it seemed so appropriate that I just do it tonight because it's really the way I feel.
Last name, please print Gasol. First Lynn, middle Rose, age older than it shows. Education, high school, must I tell the year? College, yes, but so long ago it won't count, I fear. Check one, married, single, other. Previous jobs, cooking, cleaning, housekeeping. Mother, last position held, wife. length of employment all my life. References, I think my family would say I succeeded. Reason for leaving, no longer needed. Kind of work wanted, I don't know. Would you relocate? Where would I go? Additional information, I know it won't be easy to find a job. In light of the experience I lack, my son says I can do anything I want. What I want, what I want, what I want is my whole job. On second thought, nah. I was meeting with a friend of mine about a month ago, and I was telling her the thoughts of my show, and she said, Lynn, do you realize that this decade is being coined the revenge of the grannies? You can take my castle. That's if I had a castle, and I'd miss it for a while. You can take my treasure. That's if I had a treasure, and I'd face poverty with a smile. But there's one thing I ask of you, one thing you must never do. Tear a star from out the sky, and the sky feels blue. Tear a petal from a rose, and the rose weeps too. The spark awake. Would you take the wings from birds so that they can't fly? Would you take the ocean's roar and leave just a that they can't fly. Would you take the ocean's roar and leave just a sigh? All this your heart won't let you do. This is what I beg of you, don't take your love from me. Oh, no, 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 no. Don't take your love from me.
I don't think I'll sit on this one. Let's see, there's nowhere for me to... I guess I'll lean a little.
I'd love for you to know me well. Not that well. To see me falling into place. To see the face behind the face. Behind the face. I'd love for you to see me clear, with all my virtues and my lies, with all the pleasure and the pain around the eyes. I'd like the opportunity
opportunity to show you the whole damn display. To open like a flower and to know you will stay. I hope when you look past my smile, that you'll like other parts you see, of which I hide so naturally inside of me. The things I'm not so proud of. What the hell? I'd love for you to know me. That you could take me home and take the time to work me out, to say, yes, there she is, that's what she's all about. The joy of her, the silliness, the hell. I'd love for you to know.